From here, the most important part of the debate starts. Atmeshwara devadadinam api ayathartanam eva chedgrahanam shrutito anartha praptyartham shastram iti dhruvam praptnuyat lokavadeva na chaitadishtham. Similarly, as we have seen that amitra mitra miti purusham sthanvriddhi, if a person has a wrong understanding, it will lead to evil only. Similarly, if the Atma means Self, Ishvara means God, Devadadinam, deities, etc., api, of whom we know from where? From scriptures only. Ayathartanam eva chedgrahanam shrutito. If we happen, it happens to know from the scriptures all these things which are totally void, are not existing at all, and non-entities, and not truth, ayathardhanam eva, then we'll be leading to anartha praptyartham shastram. Then the scriptures are leading us towards evil only. Just like lokavadeva, just like the scripture, the worldly things, na chaitadishtam, and that is not wished either by you or by me, from both, by both of us. Therefore, we have to accept what he says. Therefore, tathasmat yatha bhutaneva atma ishvara devadadin grahayati upasanartham shastra. Therefore, we will have to conclude that yatha bhutaneva, that the scriptures grahayati, shrutayaha should be taken over, and shastram is there. Grahayati shastram. The scriptures actually jo hai, present for meditation purpose, upasanartham, the self, God, deities, etc., which are real entities. Yatha bhutan eva, which are real entities only, such self, God, deities, etc., are being present to us by the Shruti, by the Shastra, for upasanartham, for meditation purpose only. Here starts the purpose. Bhashyakara says, whatever the Shruti says is true regarding self or God or deities, etc., whatever the Shruti is presenting is absolutely true. But the objector says, no, Shruti gives wrong understanding, false notions also. How? He says, you see, namadu brahma drishti darshanat ayuktam iti chet. He's going to explain his purpaksha again. Sputam namadira brahmattam tar brahma drishtim sthanvado yo purusha drishtim vipritam grahayat chastram drishyate. Tasmad yathardam eva shastra pratipatte shrayiti ayuktam iti chet na. He says, for the name, etc., namadav, reason is, the name, etc., which are what? In that, you are being asked to look upon them as Brahma, Brahma Drishti. Name, etc., things are seen to be meditated upon as Brahman, and that has been enjoined by the Upanishads itself. And regarding them, we know very well. Sputam bhavati. It is very clear. It is known very well. Namadir abrahmattam. Nam, etc., are all non-Brahman things. And you are asking them to look after them, look upon them as Brahman. Is it not a wrong thing? Just like a non-stump, a man is being looked upon as stump. Is it not? Just like your non-friend is an enemy, you are looking him as a friend. Similarly, it is here. A non-Brahman entity, nama, etc., name, etc., are being asked to you, the Shruti is asking you to look upon them as Brahman. It's totally vipreet understanding.
But non-friend is not even a friend, nor enemy. It is just
a mitra. No. Just now, what is it? Amitram, mitram, iti. Amitram, mitram. Amitram is a non-friend. He is being understood as friend. By amitram, you understood as enemy. An enemy is seen as a friend. Similarly, a non-Brahman is jada. యు వాంట్ టు సీ దిట్ యాజ్ చేతన. హౌ ఇస్ ఇట్ పాసిబుల్? లేదు నామ అండ్ ఎక్సెట్రా గారు ఆర్ వాట్ హీస్ అబ్రహ్మత్వం. దట్ ఈస్ వెరీ వెరీ క్లవర్ ఈస్ ద పూర్వపక్షి హియర్. ద వే యు ఆర్ యూజింగ్ ద వర్డ్ సేమ్ వర్డ్స్ ఈజ్ వాంట్స్ టు యూస్. యూ సెడ్ అమిత్రం మిత్రం, అస్థానం స్థానం. సో హీ సేస్ అబ్రహ్మ బ్రహ్మ యు ఆర్ సేయింగ్. ద శృతి ఈస్ సేయింగ్ లైక్ దట్. ఇస్ ద రాంగ్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్. దెన్ హౌ యూ జస్ట్ నౌ డిక్లేర్ దట్ వాట్ ఎవర్ శృతి ప్రజెంట్స్ ఈజ్ అబ్సల్యూట్లీ ట్రూ రిగార్డింగ్ సెల్ఫ్ అండ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. పురుషదృ స్థానవాదౌ ఇవ పురుషదృష్ట్యం విపరీతాంగ్రాయ శాస్త్రం దృశ్యతి. బట్ వి సీ వెరీ క్లియర్లీ దట్ స్క్రిప్చర్స్ ఆల్సో ఆస్క్ అస్ టు మెడిటేట్ అపాన్ సచ్ థింగ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ నాట్ బ్రహ్మన్ యాజ్ బ్రహ్మన్ డైరెక్ట్లీ అపోజింగ్ టు ద ఫ్యాక్ట్ దట్ దే ఆర్ యాక్చువల్లీ అ బ్రహ్మన్ నాట్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఎట్ ఆల్. జస్ట్ లైక్ స్థానవాద యువ పురుష దృష్టి, జస్ట్ యాజ్ వి సీ ఇన్ దిస్ వరల్డ్ దట్ అ స్టాంప్ స్థానవాద యు సీ ఇట్ యాజ్ యు పర్సీవ్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అ మ్యాన్. సిమిలర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ హ్యాపనింగ్ ఓవర్ హియర్. దేర్ఫోర్ తస్మాత్ హెన్స్ యథార్థమేవ శత ప్రతిపత్తే శ్రేయ ఇది అయుక్తం. దేర్ఫోర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ కరెక్ట్ టు సే దట్ వన్ అటైన్స్ హిస్ గోల్ శ్రేయ ప్రతిపత్తే వన్ అటైన్స్ హిస్ గోల్ గుడ్ బై అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ది థింగ్స్ యాజ్ స్టేటెడ్ బై ది శాస్త్రస్. యథార్థమేవ శాస్త్ర ప్రతిపత్తే శ్రేయ థింగ్స్ యాస్టెడ్ బై ద అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ది థింగ్స్ యాస్టెడ్ బై ది శృతి, బికాస్ ఆల్వేస్ ది శృతి స్పీక్స్ ట్రూ ఓన్లీ. దిస్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ యువర్స్ ఈస్ టోటలీ అయుక్తం ఇల్లాజికల్ ఇది చేత్ నా. సో నో, దిస్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ వాట్ యువర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఈస్ అండ్ వాట్ ఐ హ్యావ్ స్టేటెడ్. హౌ ప్రతిమావత్ భేద ప్రతిపత్తే డిఫరెన్స్ ఈస్ దేర్ యూ డోంట్ నో ద డిఫరెన్స్. In an erroneous knowledge, what's happening is, you look upon a stump as a man, not knowing that the difference between a stump and man. Is it not? But here you know the difference, that this is an idol, it is an image, this is not Vishnu. And Vishnu is different from it. Knowing that, you are just meditating on it. Therefore, this is not an erroneous knowledge like stump and man. There you don't know the difference. Because you don't know the difference of the adhisthana, with that you are the aropa which you are superimposing. Due to that you have an error, just like even shukti also. You don't know that it is shukti. The knowledge of the adhisthana, the grounds on which the superimposition takes place, is not known. The difference between both of them is not known. Once you know, once that viveka takes place, there is no way. Erroneous knowledge at all. That's why Mimamsaka say what? Avivekat. Avivekagrat Brahma. Vivekagrat Yathartha Jnana. Vivekagrat means what? Knowing the two things separately. Then there is no Brahma at all. No Bhranti. That's what Bhaskara says here. Pratima avad bhed pratipatte he. For the difference is obvious. As in the case of an image, he says. He explains now. Namadav abrahmani brahma drishtim vipiritam grahayati shastram sthanvadav iva purusha drishtim iti naitat sadhu avocha. First rejects what he said. What he has said is not right. Sadhu naitat sadhu avocha. What he has said is not right. What did he say? Namadav abrahmani. In nama etc., these things which are totally not Brahman, not self, on them you wanted you the Shastra, the scriptures, Grahayati Vipritam Brahma Drishtim, the scriptures are asking us to meditate upon them as Brahman with just a wrong understanding. Sthanvadiva Purusha Drishtim, just like analogous to regarding a stump, etc., as man, etc., iti yaduktam tvaya, that what you said thus is totally wrong. It's not right. The Purupakshi asks, why? Kasma? What is the difference between my statement and yours? It says, Bhedena hi brahmano namadu vasti pratipannasya namadu viryate brahma drishti pratimadav iva vishnu drishti. How? The question arises. He says, ஆன்சர் இஸ் பேதேனை பிரம்மணோ நாமாதி வஸ்து பிரதிபன்னஸ்ய புருஷஸ்ய பிரதியேவ. யூ டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் லைக் தட். டு சச் எ பர்சன் திஸ் இன்ஜங்ஷன் இஸ் தேர். டு ஹூ நோஸ் வெரி வெல் த டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் த பிரம்மன் அண்ட் த நேம் எக்ஸெட்ரா. ஸ்கிரிப்சர்ஸ் ஆர் என்ஜாயினிங் மெடிடேஷன் நேம் எக்ஸெட்ரா ஆஸ் அஃப் எக்ஸெட்ரா ஃபார் சச் எ பர்சன் ஹூ கிளியர்லி நோஸ் பிரதிபன்னஸ்ய பிரகட்சரூபேண பிரதிபன்னஸ்ய ஹூ நோஸ் வெரி கிளியர்லி தட் தீஸ் டூ திங்ஸ் தட் மீன்ஸ் த நேம் எக்ஸெட்ரா அண்ட் பிரம்மன் ஆர் டோட்டலி டிஃப்ரெண்ட். நாமாதி வஸ்து பிரம்மணோ பேதேன பிரதிபன்னஸ்ய. ஃபார் சச் எ பர்சன் ஓன்லி நாமாதோ பிரம்ம திருஷ்டி சாஸ்திரேண விதியதே. ஜஸ்ட் லைக் as it is seen, like meditation on an image as Vishnu etc. is being stated to such a person who knows very well that this is an image made of stone. This is not Vishnu. But still it is an enjoined to him that you meditate this on this as Brahman, on the as Vishnu. Similarly here it is. So why it is being done so? Well, that Bhaskara explains. Alambaratvene namadi pratipatti பிரதிமாதிவ தேவ நது நாமாதி ஏவ பிரம்ம இது. ஸ்ருதி த ஸ்கிரிப்சர்ஸ் நெவர் சே தென் நாம இஸ் பிரம்மன். இட் இஸ் நாட் சே ஜட இஸ் பிரம்மன். நாட் சேயிங் சோ. இஸ் நாட் சேயிங் சோ அட் ஆல். பட் வாட் இட் இஸ் சேயிங்? ஆலம்பனத்வேனஹி. ஜஸ்ட் லைக் த இமேஜ் எக்ஸெட்ரா பிரதிமாதிவ தேவ த நேம் எக்ஸெட்ரா are used merely as a media or as a means or aids of meditation. Alambanatvena means or an aid of meditation, a means of meditation, or the mode to be used for meditation. Natu, and never the scriptures say namadi eva brahmaiti, nama itself, the name etc. itself is Brahman. This is not being stated by the Shruti. யதா ஸ்தானௌ அநிர்யாதே நஸ்தானுரிதி புருஷயே வயமிதி பிரதிபத்தே விபரீதம் நது ததா நாமாதோ பிரம்ம திருஷ்டி விபரீதா. மே மோர் கிளியர் இஸ் மேக்கிங் அவர் யா. பிகாஸ் சோ லாங் ஆஸ் யதா ஸ்தானௌ அநிர்யாதே, தட் மீன்ஸ் டு சே யாவத் ஸ்தானௌ அநிர்யாதே அன்டில் அண்ட் அன்லெஸ் ஆர் ஆஸ் லாங் ஆஸ் ஒன் டஸ் நாட் perceive a stump as a stump, but na sthanu ritti, but he mistakes it as for a man, thinking that this is not a stump. Sthanau anirgyate, as long as a person is not perceiving this stump, and what is thinking therefore, na sthanu ritti, this is not a stump, but what it is then? புருஷ ஏவாயம், திஸ் மேன் ஓன்லி இது பிரதிபத்தியதே. இன் திஸ் வே ஹி இஸ் பர்சீவிங். சச் நாலேஜ் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் எரோனியஸ் நாலேஜ். நது ததா அண்ட் லைக் தட் இட் இஸ் நாட் பீ ஸ்டெட் ஓவர் ஹியர் இன் த கேஸ் ஆஃப் நாமாதவ் பிரம்ம திருஷ்டி. செல்ஃப் இஸ் நாட் பீங் ஆஸ்ட் டு மெடிடேட் அப்பான் நாம எக்ஸெட்ரா. In this you know that this is name different from Brahman. There you don't know that this is stump different from man. And then you are not superimposing man on this stump. Knowing this, nobody will do. But here, knowingly it is being done. That's the difference. Knowing this is a stone image, we think it is as Brahma, Vishnu and do puja. Knowing that it's just a paper, not just a paper, photo of gods you keep and you do aarti, puja, paath and everything, cry and do all the things in front of it, knowing the difference. But in an erroneous way, what happens? Without knowing the superimposition taking place, we say it is a superimposition, because once we realize the what on which we are, the grounds on which we are being superimposing, not before that. Before we don't know that it is a superimposed knowledge. Before we don't even know there is an erroneous knowledge, we are thinking it's right. What I am seeing is right. My knowledge is perfect. But once you know that neidam rajitam, then only you realize, oh, I had superimposed up to now this silver on the neck. Not before that. But here it's not like that. From the very beginning we know the difference between both. And still we are superimposing just for meditation purpose to make our mind concentrate. That's the reason.
We invoke the Lord in that idol. When we invoke the Lord in that idol, that idol is the Lord. Then we do all
that. But still we know that this is an idol.
But once we have invoked, he is no more an idol. He is the Lord himself sitting in front of me.
That is your imagination.
That's your bhavana.
That is your bhavana. That's what saying. In truly speaking, it is a stone itself, but our bhavana is its deity.
No more a stone. After you invoke the Lord, it becomes the Lord itself.
That you may say so, but it is a stone itself, no doubt. That's why this fight is going on nowadays. The Ram Mandir is what the problem. Muslims say it's a stone, you can keep it anywhere. We are, for our minds, Rama, therefore how can we keep him anywhere? This is the fight.
They can also build their mask anywhere.
But this is what's happening. That's what the answer replied to them also.
They were not even worshipping.
It's just a political drama, nothing else. Once person, the own Quran is written 40 years, if they don't worship in a masjid, it's not a masjid at all, it's worthless. Yeah. It's stated very clearly. Right. And for even more than 100 years, they have not done that. This is a question at all, is being a masjid. But actually there are many other things also, the stories depend upon. Once we do the prana pratishtha and everything is only a mental bhavana. And because of bhavanas, we get the results also from that particular image. That's the main reason, therefore we accept the Vishnu itself, it's Rama itself, Krishna itself and everything.
Because in our mind, it is no more a stone. In our mind, it is the Lord himself.
That superimposition takes place in an erroneous knowledge also is not known before, but here it's known before. That's the difference. Because of this difference, you can't say here it's just like Sthana Purusha. Can't take that as an analogous here.
Because here it's a deliberate superimposition.
Yes.
There it's a
unknown superimposition. Now Mimamsaka says actually there's no God at all, no deities at all. What are you speaking about? There's no self at all. Brahma drishti reva kevala nasti brahma iti chet. Okay, I accept there is Brahma drishti, you can think so, but actually there is no Brahman at all. There is only meditation on name etc. that is being enjoined by the scriptures. Actually there is nothing called as self or God or deities or anything. Because in Mimamsaka, the 9th chapter, out of the 12 chapters, most important chapter is the 9th chapter there. In that they say, what is the necessity of accepting a God or a deity? Question has been raised. The reasons were given by Astikas, you see, because we think that he has created us. But this creation is that, what is the necessity of him? Because he is also creating according to, depending upon my karma, then why my karma also directly conduit? Number one. Then he says, okay, for phalam, who is going to keep the account of all the karmas and give the phalam for that one? That is not necessary. When karma can create the srishti, why can't karma can give the phalam also? He rejects five things. This is one beautiful shloka by them. Vigraho havisham bhoga aishwaryancha prasannada phaladatrit panchityetat panchakam vigrahadikam. The five things of deities which are vigrahadikam, five things, is rejected by them. First is vigraho. They have a body and they can create whichever type of body they like at their will and wish. All this is being stated by our deities and gods. Said we never accept anything that they have a body. Number two, havisham bhoga. That whatever we are giving here, that is being enjoyed by them. We don't accept that. Mantra is itself devata. There's the Mimamsaka Siddhanta. Mantra are themselves devata. There's nothing other than mantra as devata. Aishwaryancha, they have got different types of treasures. There's a capacity to attain treasures and all, siddhis and riddhis. So we don't accept even that. What?
Rulership.
Rulership also. Because for ruler only we have to make prasannam. Na prasannata also. They are not even rulers of us. Because why they have to rule? Manas.
Eh?
Well, that also they are not necessary. Is it because they say these elemental things have got their own capacity to have a process of their own. How? They say, why should we think about a potato is getting rotten? Due to some deity? You keep a potato, and because of air and wind and rain and sunlight and all those things, many reasons are there, it slowly becomes rotten and disintegrates. It then takes place and depends upon the prarabdha of the potato. Why don't you say so? Why you want to think there also some deity is there? He made it so.
Time.
So let it. Why don't you accept time and karma only to everything? Why want to ask some deity? He has to rule on us. He has to maintain everything. He has to control everything. Nothing is needed. He says everything is arranged by karma only.
That's what the modern scientists also think. They're
all junior Mimamsakas. Faladatritvancha. Last he says they give fruits, and that is wrong. If they have got the capacity to give the fruits, I will not do anything. Let them give. Why don't they give? When I do, then I get. That means I get because I am doing, not because they give us. Therefore, these five things they reject. Vigraho havisham bhoga aishwaryancha prasannata faladhatritanchetyetat panchakam vigrahadikam kumarli bhatt. Vartik. That's why they say here, Brahma Drishtadeva. In all the upasanas and all the meditations, we are asked to look upon one thing as another thing. That's all. But it's not essential, it's not necessary to accept that those things do exist which are being superimposed. Therefore, nasti Brahma. There's nothing called as a Brahman or God or deity or anything. He explains his own statement. Yetena pratima brahmanadisho vishnumadi deva pitradi drishtinan tulyata. Because this meditation which has been stated by you, yetena, of meditation name etc. as Supreme Self to be true, that what you stated, then it is just like regarding the pratima images as Vishnuadi, Vishnu etc. and brahmanadishu, and you have to see brahmana, the caste as pitra, the pitra dev, the mains etc. is just like that only. A brahmana cannot become a main just because you see him as a main. Cannot become pitra devata. Similarly, an image you may see it as a Vishnu, but the image will never become Vishnu. So it is with this also, a name can never become Brahman. You can see, you can just meditate upon name as Brahman. As in the reason he says is because the reason is the name, just like the Pitar or the Vishnu etc. does not exist. If they would have been, they would have come through that image also. They would have come through Brahman also, but they don't come. You never say experience such.
They don't do Shraddha.
Huh?
They don't do Shraddha Karma.
They do. Yes, but they need not. They don't want in Devata for that. The mantra is of Devata.
Pitru you have to invoke in the Brahman.
The mantra, you are doing a mantra only is not. The mantra is of Pitru. Agni Shvata Agachha is a mantra. And then mantra is of Devata. There is nothing, I know Agni Shvata Devata somewhere is sitting and he will come over here. Nothing like that. We say the mantra, by mantra we are invoking. The mantra is itself Devata. And we chant that, the Devata is invoked. That's all. Invoking a deity means chanting that mantra. The whole of karma kanda is like that only. Not only in Pitri Karma, again everything, everywhere, every karma they do say so. Mm-hmm. That's why here he says, just like that only. Therefore, as we have never seen any Pitri up to this day, never we have seen any Vishnu coming and going and doing, accepting anything, and eating and drinking or doing any such thing over here. Therefore, we don't accept any such things at all. Bhashyakara says, no. All superimpositions are not like that. A non-existent thing is not superimposed for meditation in all meditations. Because there are such meditations which we are seeing, an existing thing is being superimposed. Like, Rigadishu Prithivyadi Drishti Darshanat. You ask that Vimamsaka, is this not Prithivi? Are you seeing it or not? Yes, I see this is Prithivi. And you have been asked to meditate this Prithvi on Rig, on Rig Veda. Are you going to meditate or not? Mimamsakas have to say, yes. Then, is there an existing thing or not? So that means there are meditations in which existing things are superimposed. Therefore, Brahman is also existing, which is being superimposed on me. See the yukti. Regarishu prithivyaya drishti darshanat. For it has been enjoined in the same scriptures to meditate upon Rig Veda as prithivi, etc. विद्यमान पृथिव्यादि वस्तु दृष्टिनाम एव रिगादि विषये प्रक्षेप दर्शनात्. बिकॉज हियर वी सी ओनली अ प्रक्षेप अ सुपर इम्पोजिशन इज बीइंग सीन ओवर हियर ऑन रिग एक्सेट्रा ऑफ द रियल थिंग विद्यमान दैट विच इज एग्जिस्टिंग पृथिव्यादि वस्तु earth etc. things vastu drishti naam their meditation is being prakshepa superimposed on rigadi vishe on things like rigveda etc. this is what is darshana seen over here. Most important word is vidyaman. It's not an avidyaman. For him the purpaksha saying avidyamana brahman avidyamana pitridevata avidyamana vishnu devata was being superimposed on a pratima or on brahmana or on nama etc. But here there's an example is being given with vidyamana prativyadi vastu eva drishtinam eva rigadi vishe prakshepa darshana tasmat. Therefore I conclude over here that tat samanyat on the analogous of that we conclude siddhi. Means we establish this. What? Namadishu Brahma Drishti, Brahma Drishti Naam Vidyamana Brahma Adivishattam Eva. That meditation on name etc. as self, super self etc. is based on those, that super self which is actually existing. Vidyamana Brahma Adivishattam Eva. Brahma Drishti Naam Namadishu Siddhihi. Thus we establish or we conclude in this way, depending upon the analogous of Rig and Prithvi. Etena. And now, once this has been established, then existing thing can be superimposed. Therefore, we say now we regard Vishnu and Pitra also, and they are also existing. In this way, every god, every deity, everything is existing, which has been superimposed on another thing. Etena. Pratima. ब्राह्मणादिषु विष्णुवादि देव पित्रादि बुद्धिनांच सत्य वस्तु विषयत्व सिद्धि. नॉट ओनली विद्यमान वस्तु बट भाष्यकार सेज नाउ हियर सत्य वस्तु विषयत्वम विषयत्व सिद्धि. बाय दिस इट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड द मेडिटेशन ऑन इमेजेस एज विष्णु एक्सेट्रा एंड ऑन ब्राह्मण एज पितृ एक्सेट्रा द मेन्स एक्सेट्रा आर बेस्ड ऑन वॉट सत्य वस्तु विषयत्व सिद्धि ही are based on real things that are existing somewhere else. Mukhya apekshatvach gonatvasya, another reason. That was only an example, Rig Prithvi. This is the actual reason now. The argument given to the Mimamsakas. Mukhya apekshatvach gonatvasya. For any figurative sense, it depends upon a primary thing. There should be a primary thing depending upon which you can have a figurative sense elsewhere. Is Gauna Prayoga is that because Singo Manavaka. If there is nothing called a singa in the forest, how you can just figuratively use it for a boy? You can use the word singa figuratively once it has a primary sense elsewhere. Is Mukhya Apekshatta. Depending upon the primary sense only, a word is used elsewhere in its figurative sense. Just like example, he says, Panchagniyadi shucha, agritvade, gaunatvat, mukhyadhyad sadbhavad, namashi brahmatvase gaunatvat, mukhya brahmasadbhav upattihi. Just like in Panchagni, for instance, is giving Panchagniyadi shucha. What are the five fires? Five fires are the heaven, Dyurloka, Parjanya, second, number two, the clouds, number three, being the Prithvi, the earth, fourth is the Purusha, fifth is the woman. Are these actually fires? No. On these you have been asked to meditate as fire. That is, the word fire is being used in figurative sense for dew, etc. That means to say, the word fire has its primary sense elsewhere, which is well known in this world as fire, by which we usually cook, etc. Similarly, it's with Navam Brahmana. Agnitvadeh, Prithvyagni, Prithvi, Panchagni, Agniadishu, Chagnitvadeh, Gaunatvad. For instance, the five fires which are meditated upon as fire, in there, the word fire is in a sense always figurative only, is not being used in its primary sense. Gaunatva, Mukhya Agniya Sadbhava, what? By that, you actually can imply there is elsewhere the true fire for which the word fire is being used with its primary sense. Similarly, he says, since the name, etc., Namadishu, Brahmatvasya Gaunatvat, the word of Brahman and meditation of them as Brahman is being used over here figuratively. Therefore, Mukhya Brahma Sadbhava Upapatti Syat. Depending upon that, surely we have to accept that logically this can be proved, that the existence of Brahman in its real sense with the word Brahman is elsewhere existing. Not only this, Kriyarthaischa Aviveshesat Vidyarthana. Another reason. Mukhyapekshatvaccha Gaunatvasya, the first argument. Second argument is Kriyarthaischa Visheshat Vidyarthana. This also a big debate now. It's just a pratigya vakya by Bhashyam. Besides this, another thing he says, Kriyarthaihi, matters pertaining to Vidyarthanam, knowledge, are similar to, he says, Avisheshat means are similar, exactly the same, akin to those pertaining to the rites, Kriyarthai. All matters pertaining to knowledge, Vidyarthanam, are akin to matters pertaining to the rites. How? He is going to explain now his own statement. Yatha cha darshapurnamasadi kriya evam phala visheshteti kartavyataka evam krama prayukta prayuktanga cha ityetad alaukikam vasto pratyakshadi avishayam tatha bhutancha vedavakyere vyapyate. You see, for instance, darshapurnamasa yaga is there, like the rites that are performed on the new moon day and the full moon days. Darshapurnamasadi kriya, the sacrifices performed, the rites performed on the new moon day and full moon day, called as Darshapurnamasa Yaga. How are they? Evam phala. That you decide, they give this particular result only, you know well. And also you know, Vishishtiti Kartavataka. And then you know that having done in a definite manner, definite way, and that too, evam krama prayuktanga, with their parts following each other in a particular order. That too is how? Etad alaukikam. Iti etad, all these things, all these matters regarding the Darshapurnamasa rites are alaukikam, are supersensuous things. Alaukikam vastu. Pratyakshadi avishyam, which are the matters beyond the range of perception, inference, etc., etc., the means of knowledge. Tatha bhutancha, even though they are such, all that you do accept. Why? Because vedavakyere vagyapyate, because you understand them properly and perform those rites accordingly, because they are being known and stated by the Veda mantras, Veda vakya. Similarly is with Brahman. Even this is a supersensuous matter. Tatha paramatma ishvara devadadi vastu asthuladi dharmakam asanayadyati tancha iti evam adi visishtam इति वेदवाक्यरेव ज्ञाप्यते इति अलौकिकत्वात् तथा भूतमेव भवितुम् अर्हति। सो विंदो एज यू सी देयर आर प्रत्यक्षादि अविषयम बट स्टिल वी डू एक्सेप्ट देम एज स्टेटेड बाय द वेदास एंड वी एक्सेप्ट देम एज तथा भूतम दे आर ऑल ट्रू एज इट इज। सिमिलरली हियर आल्सो यू से तथा परमात्मा ईश्वर परमात्मा इज द सुपर द सुप्रीम सेल्फ ईश्वर मीन्स गॉड देवता मीन्स डेटीज आदि मीन्स एक्सेट्रा वस्तु विद रिगार्ड टू ऑल दिस थिंग्स ऑल्सो विच आर हाउ कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय अस्थूलाय धर्मगम दे आर कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द एब्सेंस ऑफ ग्रॉसनेस एंड अशनयाद्यधीतम एंड ऑल्सो स्टेटेड दे आर बीइंग बियॉन्ड हंगर एक्सेट्रा वेद इत्यादि इत्येवं मारि विशिष्टम इन दिस वे दे आर कैरेक्टराइज्ड दिस थिंग्स यू आर नोइंग थ्रू वेदवाक्यरेव ज्ञाप्यते ऑल दीज आर नोन बाय द वेदस ओनली एज एंड बिकॉज दे आर ऑल्सो अलौकिकत्वात् दे आर ऑल्सो सुपर सेंशियस थिंग्स फॉर दे आर ऑल सो जस्ट लाइक द राइट्स दे आर ऑल्सो सुपर सेंशियस एंड नॉट ओनली दैट दस you have to decide that tatha bhutam eva that they all the two must be true as the rights bhavitum arhati that should be so nach kriyartir vakya gyan vakyanam buddhyutpadakatva visheshosti not only that there is no difference at all na visheshosti there is no difference at all between the sentences that are mentioning the karmakanda and the sentences that are mentioning the jnanakanda as the sentences of the vedas propagate certain meaning proper understanding they are giving or they produce certain perfect notion regarding their things similarly it is with the vedanta vakya also kriyarthair vakya jnana vakyana buddhi in notion or knowledge utpatti utpadakatve in the production of the knowledge there is no visheshavasti no difference at all between the texts related to the knowledge and those texts related to the rites there is no difference at all in the production of the knowledge by them nacha anischita viparyasthava parmatmadi vastu vishaya buddhirutpadyate and you can't even say this and also the vedas neither produce an indefinite anischita means indefinite knowledge or viprastha means contrary bilkul misunderstanding knowledge with regard to the entities like supreme self parmatma adi means god deities etc vastu vishaya buddhi na utpadyate they never produce such a knowledge at all therefore you have to accept as you are accepting the karmakanda ho mimansaka similarly you have to accept the jnanakanda also you can't say this deity is god the supreme self is not existing at all you have to accept that they are existing and they too are terminated upon with a certain definite way to attain a definite result called moksha liberation.